fucking out the news.
Good news?
Mostly bad news.
What's wrong?
Forest fires, coronavirus, and there's a lot of snow.
Is news always bad?
Yeah, it seems like that sometimes. But good news is always in the family and the world and the communities. Whenever I feel like everything's bad, I think about
Jesus.
How'd you know that?
Cause I'm smart.
Jesus. Yeah, I think of Jesus, New Life, and Easter.
Didn't Jesus get killed?
Yeah. But his story is about how good triumphed over evil.
Sermon on, that sounds like Sermon on the Mount. We'd learned that in Sunday school.
Yeah, the Sermon on the Mount was where many people came to listen to Jesus on a mountain.
Sounds like a sermon. Sermon's alright.
Not for the people that traveled for like who knows how far to go listen to him and listen to him talk about Jesus and, well, God.
That.
He talked about God's kingdom.
That does sound like good news.
Yeah. Jesus told them how God's kingdom was open to people who were sad, lonely, poor, and sick.
That does sound like good news.
Tell us more, Jesus.
Tell us about the kingdom of heaven.
How do we get into this kingdom?
What do? Do we have to offer sacrifices?
Is there an entry fee? Is it invitation only?
Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will open for you. Everyone who asks receives. Everyone who seeks finds. And to those who knock, the door will be opened.
Ask for what exactly?
And where do we knock? Is it a big door?
Where is this door?
Are you saying that we just ask and God will give things to us?
I want a puppy.
I need a new tunic.
And a camel.
Does God know my size?
Where are these things God's giving us? Behind the door?
Shh. Let Jesus explain.
All right, let me ask you this. Which of you, if your child asks for bread, would you give them a stone? Or if they ask for fish, will you give them a snake?
What? No.
Never. Who does that?
That's just me.
Exactly. You know how to give good gifts to your children, so just imagine how good God's gift will be to those who ask.
Oh, I see what you did there.
Nice.
God loves you just like a loving parent. God's kingdom is a kingdom of love. Share that love. In everything you do, treat others the way you want to be treated. That is the kingdom of God.
Oh. That's a good rule.
That is golden. So wise.
I gotta listen to this guy for
this. Now let me tell you about the wide gate and the narrow gate.
Wait, there's a gate now?
See the good that we do and give glory. Blessed are they who are meek and humble, they will inherit the earth.
Bless us, O Lord, make us meek and humble. Bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world. May our lives shine before all, that they may see the good that we do and give glory.
Blessed are they who will mourn in sorrow, they will be comforted.
Bless us, O Lord, when we share the sorrow, bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world.
Is one of my favorite Bible passages.
Does anything else happen?
Yeah, Jesus taught the people a lot.
More talking? That seems kind of boring, like boring news.
Well, that can be true. Good news isn't really good news if it's all talk.
Sometimes people talk too much.
That's very true. How's your hot chocolate?
Good. How's your coffee?
I am all out.
You should have some of this.
It does look good.
Really good.
Hey, can you think of a time when Jesus not only said something good, but did something good?
He was nice to Mary Magdalene when everyone else was mean to her.
That's a good one.
Or Zacchaeus. Nobody liked Zacchaeus, and Jesus came over and ate at his house. That was a big deal.
It was.
Or when the kids wanted... grown-ups wanted the kids to leave Jesus alone, and Jesus was like, kids, get over here, and gave them all hugs and candy.
Maybe not candy.
Ooh, what about the time when Jesus fed 5 gazillion hungry people?
The feeding of the thousands?
Yeah!
That's a really great example. Jesus fed all those hungry people when his own disciples thought there wasn't enough food.
Food is good news.
Food is good news.
Jesus, we're in the middle of nowhere and it's getting late. We should send the crowd away so that they can go get themselves food in the village.
Why would we send them away? Just give them something to eat.
So we only have 5 loaves of bread and... 2 fish.
What's the problem?
Well, mathematically speaking, there's thousands of people, Jesus. We couldn't possibly...
Bring the food to me.
But we're hungry, too.
Coming right up.
Everyone, please sit down on the grass. Holy God, thank you for these loaves of bread and these fish. You are a lovely God who gives us good gifts. Amen.
All right, we've got a little bit of food here. Everyone needs to share.
Please don't take too much.
There's only so much to go around.
That's it. Pass it around, don't spill it.
Thank you.
Here's some more.
Ooh, I want some.
Here's a lot more.
Who wants seconds?
For third.
Yeah,
thank you.
Oh, thank you. Bless you.
Switch.
Switch. Oh, no, I'm full.
Everyone says they're full. They're all full, but where did, how did, I think we just witnessed a miracle.
Hi, Falcon Club, we're hungry. Hi, Falcon Club, we're Halloween, Jesus. Hi, Falcon Club, hi, Falcon Club, Halloween, Jesus. Hi, Falcon Club, following Jesus, it was dinner time.
Send them away to the villages, send them away to the villages, send them away to the villages, it was dinner time.
Yes, you can feed them, yes, you can feed them, yes, you can feed them, bring me what you got.
Loaves and two fishes, five boy loaves and two fishes, five boy loaves and two fishes, that is all we have.
Give it to the Lord and he will use it. Give it to the Lord and he will use it. Give it to the Lord and he will use it. It's enough for him.
Set the people down in groups of 50. Set the people down in groups of 50. Set the people down in groups of 50. Let them all be fed.
Everybody saw it that way.
But you said Jesus was all about good news.
Sometimes good news for some is bad news for others. When Jesus told the people who didn't have a lot of power that they were blessed, that made community and religious leaders, kings, and even the emperor angry and fearful. They were scared Jesus' message would make them lose their power.
And they didn't want that.
No, they did not.
A lot.
Where do you see that happen?
Well, when people think they're better or more important than others, it makes them feel powerful and control like a bully.
But power isn't the most important thing, is it?
Nope. Love is.
You know it. Jesus lived a life of love for the people, teaching and showing that God loved them no matter who they were. And that's why people in power made a plan to arrest Jesus the same night he and his disciples were having a special meal.
Thank you. missing.
Who needs some more bread?
Over here, James.
There you are, James.
Thank you, James.
Wine, anyone?
Oh, yes. I'll take it.
Of course.
Teacher, would you tell us that funny story again? The one about your parents, losing you for 3 days.
I love that one. Where have you been? We were worried sick. And then you said,
where else would I be but my father's house?
I do love that story. But tonight, there's something else that I need to share with you. Something serious. This meal is more special than you think. I need you here with me because soon I will suffer greatly. God, thank you for this wine. Take this cup and take a drink, each of you. I am not going to drink again until God's kingdom comes. God, thank you for this bread. This is my body, which is given to you. Do this to remember me. This cup poured out to you is the new covenant in my blood. Friends, I always knew that I was going to suffer. No one can change that. And one of you is going to betray me.
Not I.
Nor me.
I would never.
No way. I'm your number one fan.
No, I'm his number one fan. You know that, John.
He loves Peter more than you, Matthew.
You will all desert me. You will all scatter and hide at the time of my suffering, but I have prayed that your faith will not fail you, that you will come back together and serve and strengthen one another.
Jesus, you know I would go to jail for you. I would die for you.
Peter, before the sun rises tomorrow, you will pretend that you don't know me. 3 times. These are difficult times. Come, put on your sandals and let us go where we can pray. I'm going to pray alone. Stay here and pray with me.
Yes, teacher.
Of course, Jesus.
Father, if it is possible, take this cup of suffering out of my hands. Yet, not what I want, but what you want. Why are you sleeping? Come up and pray with me in the face of these hard times.
Yes, teacher.
Look, it's Judas. He's come with our men.
They come here with their weapons drawn, as if I'm an armed robber. I was with people day after day in the temple, and they did not lay a hand on me. But they are going to do what they are going to do. This is a troubling time, a time of suffering.
innocent, but that didn't matter to the people in power.
Why?
People with power often don't want their world to change, and Jesus's message of love and justice was changing everything. So they wanted to silence him.
Talk about bad news.
Bad news for Jesus and all of his followers. When Jesus was arrested, some of his disciples were so frightened they ran away and hid.
I would too. I'd hide under my bed.
Bad news is hard to face, especially when it's scary bad.
But the power people didn't win, did they?
What do you think?
Well, they did kill Jesus, but first they tried to embarrass him and hurt him.
Yes, they did.
Then they killed him.
They did. It's a sad, horrible story.
That's the worst news.
It really was. But it wasn't the end, was it?
Nope.
There was good news to come.
Huge good news.
Easter news.
Yeah.
Do you know who were the very first preachers of that good Easter news? Women.
Of course they were. Which ones?
Well, we're not sure who all was there, but we know it was a group of women who went out to visit the tomb where Jesus's body was buried.
Joanna, I have not stopped crying for 2 days. I miss him so much. How can he be gone, our beloved teacher and friend? Remember when he healed my son's hand on the Sabbath? Or when he stood up to the religious leaders accusing me of sin?
He was always there for us, serving everyone.
And challenging everyone. Oh, he never let you off the hook, that's for sure.
He said God has sent me to proclaim release to the captives. The people in charge didn't like that.
No, they didn't. And they took him away from us.
Look, at the tomb, the stone has been removed.
Someone has stolen his body.
Why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here. He is risen.
What?
Jesus is risen.
No way.
Yes way.
You can't be serious.
Did you miss our super glittery outfits? It doesn't seem to get more serious than this.
Remember what Jesus said to you in Galilee? He told you that he would be killed and then rise again on the third day.
He did. He totally did.
Go tell the other disciples that Jesus is going ahead of you to Galilee.
There you will see him, just as he told you.
This is actually happening. This is incredible.
So, Jesus.
Come on, we have to tell the others, right?
But they'll never believe us.
It doesn't matter. God wants us to share the good news with everyone, whether they believe us or not. Hallelujah, sister. Let's go.
Thank you.
So did anyone believe the women?
Not at first. They thought that news was too good to be true. The disciples eventually figured it out, though.
They had to see the empty tomb for themselves.
That's right. And later on, Jesus appeared to some of the disciples. He was risen. And the disciples began to realize that Jesus saved his biggest news for last.
The super good news?
The good news that death and the biggest, baddest news doesn't have to be the last word. That there is new life, hope, and possibility in the power of the resurrection.
But how come there's still bad news, like, a lot?
Well, unfortunately, Aaron, there will always be some bad news in the world. And like the disciples, you may feel like giving up sometimes. But after Jesus' resurrection, the disciples stopped hiding, went out into the world, and continued to preach his ministry. They reached out to all kinds of people who were used to hearing only bad news, and they taught them about love and acceptance and forgiveness. And then they cared for the sick and fed the poor. They visited people in prison. They shared everything they had. They weren't just talking the talk about the good news of Jesus. They were also walking the walk about the good news of Jesus.
They did all of that?
Yes. And the good news about that is that you and I can also continue the ministry of Jesus by going out and living and sharing the good news of Jesus today.
Followers of Jesus still bring good news to ourselves, our families, our friends, and our neighbors. Our church congregation follows in the way of Jesus when we provide canned food goods for our sanctuary's soup shelf. Donating land to Habitat for Humanity to help build houses for families that need them. Continue to have a place for childcare through the Early Learning Center. Collecting diapers, undies, wipes, feminine hygiene products. Augustana Foundation supports ministries in our congregation and community organizations. Breaking down rice and beans for Metro Caring. And providing food baskets for Warren Village. And much more. When we do these things, we are responding to Jesus' call to live out the scripture of Luke 4. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because God has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. God has sent me to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor.
When the bad news of our world feels overwhelming, we can reach out to one another, support and strengthen each other, and remind each other that the message of Jesus lives on in us and through us.
That's the best news!
And you know, if you're ever feeling discouraged by bad news, I'll want you to come to me and I'll remind you of the good news Jesus is still bringing into the world.
And if you forget, I'll remind you.
You always do. We all need to be reminded there's good news.
Every day.